I'm Fred Grubb, owner of Rocky Mountain Construction.
Hi, Fred. Great to see you again.
It's great to see you.
This time we're seeing each other nice early on in the season here because you're opening your first new coaster.
Yeah. Twisted Timbers. Yes. It's a great, great ride. Right. It's a great addition to this park.
Right, and I've seen you riding it. Was today your first time riding it?
No, I rode it yesterday. Yesterday was the first time. I came in yesterday, rode it, and we checked things out, did some inspections, and hopped on again today. It's great.
Right, and just as you expected.
Just as I expected. It's really good.
That's the thing about you and Alan. You design these things up, you put them all out there, and then there's no surprises. They run exactly as you guys designed them to run.
They do, yes.
So, let's talk about this a little bit more. This is a conversion coaster for you. This was Hurler, the old wooden coaster, and now you've converted it.
Yep.
So can you tell us a little bit about that process and what went on there?
Well, it's this, Alan did a great job designing and putting the track on this coaster. We were able to get a couple inversions out of it, a lot of air time. I think there's 20 moments of air time. So it's been a great project. The site was really unique because a lot of it was hard to get to. So we had to take a lot of structure down to get inside of it to build, get the cranes in and so forth. But it's went well, and it's been on schedule. Everything has went as planned.
Right. Well, it's opening tonight. Is the preview for pass holders?
Yeah.
The park is opening this weekend, and the coaster is running.
It's running fine.
Yeah. I mean, that is on schedule.
No glitches so far.
Yeah. Well, I think it's a little late to be starting having glitches now.
Well, I always say that. You know, you always got to qualify everything. You know.
Right.
Yeah.
So now you just mentioned something that was interesting to me. You had to take down a lot of the structure because normally you tend to leave a lot of the structure in these type of
Well, what I'm saying is we had to take down some structure and so forth just to do staging, just to get it built. So then, of course, you move into that section, you work your way out, and then you put that structure back in. So it's been, you know, every time you go to a rebuild, you have a unique situation that you have to deal with.
Right, right. But there's still a lot of the old structure.
Oh, yeah. Most of it's all old original structure.
Right, yes. But you have replaced that old sideways slamming turn now with the nice huge overbank curve that pushes the train, just pushes you right through that thing.
Right. And that's all new over there. So,
right. Yeah. And you got this barrel roll drop that was similar to what we have out in Kentucky Kingdom on Storm Chaser. And so it seems to me like you've kind of combined a couple of things here. Maybe something like Wicked Cyclone up in New England combined with some of the stuff from Storm Chaser. But if you've ridden one or the other of those, that doesn't mean that necessarily you know what's going to happen here. This is unique ride.
This is unique. It's totally custom. It's unique. Yeah.
Right. And then, speaking of unique, we've got, this isn't the only coaster that's opening this year for Rocky Mountain Construction. This is a very busy year for you guys, isn't it?
Very busy. We've got five openings this is one of the five that are going to happen. This is the first of the five.
Can you tell us a little bit about what the other ones are?
Yep. We have an opening in Georgia for Six Flags. We have, obviously, the old Mean Streak, now called Steel Vengeance. And that's going to open. We're just in testing phases and so forth of it right now. We have our two new Raptor rides opening.
Where are they?
One's in Texas and one's in California's Great Adventure and Six Flags Fiesta Texas.
Right.
So we are, and we are extremely excited about those. In fact, one of them has been ridden. And it's extremely exciting. They are going to be very unique, very different rides.
Which one has been ridden?
Well, I'm gonna leave that up to the viewers. But we're testing one, and they're very, very unique. And I'll be heading there in about 3 or 4 days, and we'll.
Right.
We'll be commissioning and finishing it up.
For our viewers that don't know exactly what you're talking about, can you tell us why those two are unique?
Well, because it's the what we call the Raptor track, and it's the single rail track. The track is only 15 inches wide, So it's very pleasing to the eye, and it's a different ride. Hasn't been done like this before, and so we're very excited. So working all the bugs out and getting ready to open one up.
So it's
and
a brand new type of ride, brand new type of track,
brand new cars.
Yeah, brand new type of cars, right?
Brand new type of cars.
What's the different about those cars than the other Rocky Mountain?
You ride the ride like you would ride on a motorcycle, or you ride right over the top of the track with your legs. So your legs actually straddle the track, like you'd ride a horse or a motorcycle. So it gives a whole new feeling and a whole new experience.
Are you in a car, though?
Yeah, you're in
a... Or is it open like on a motorcycle?
No, you're in a car. You're in a single seat. The cars are in line, single seat in line, and you're in a car with a restraint system. But the thing is on each side of you, you're open, you know. So it's a very unique experience.
Okay, well,
very unique.
Right. And then, of course, you mentioned Minsk. Well, first of all, we'll go back. Six Flags. There you're doing another conversion as at Cedar Point you're doing a conversion.
Exactly, yeah.
Six Flags over Georgia, you're doing the old Cyclone.
Right.
So that, again, is that going to be similar to this?
Be similar.
Or yeah, more similar to another one maybe that we've already experienced? The Cyclone up in New England?
It'll be similar to the New England Cyclone. Yeah,
right,
similar.
Right. But again, it'll be unique.
It'll be unique and different.
Right, because each one of these...
Each one has all their independent, their own elements in them, you know. So each one has their own uniqueness, elements. We try to mix it up so that
let's talk real quick about the one that the people are... talking about the most. And I know you're excited about your new Raptor coasters.
Yeah.
But there's something about the conversion of Mean Streak into Steel Vengeance that has really captured the imagination of just about everyone.
Can
you tell us a little bit about that?
That is, obviously, it is very large, very big, very long. It's exciting for us. I'm excited to get on that, ride it. And
it's by far the biggest coaster our Rocky Mountain Construction has taken on, right?
Well, it sets records. It sets the height record and so forth for wood coasters.
Because, I mean, you started off with the big one in Texas Giant.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that was a really big coaster. Mm-hmm. Then since then, it seems like there's been nothing quite that size until now with Mean Street.
Well,
this is that size and then some.
Yeah, it's that size and then some. So We've had the Dollywood coaster, and those are big. Those are really big. Rattler's big down in Fiesta, Texas. So this is just a little bit bigger than all of them.
Right.
Yeah. So we're very excited.
Right.
And it's longer, you know.
Was there something that you had to do that's different from the company's point of view particularly for Mean Streak? That's something that you haven't had to deal before in the past?
Well, the main thing is we've had to do some different things. Now, we've got new cars on these coasters. You've noticed these are new cars. So we developed new cars. Up at Mean Streak, we had to plan a two-year project. We had to make a two-year project out of it just because of the sheer volume of what's there. The height, the enormity of it. So we've had to plan it as a two-year project just to get it done.
Right. So
typically we can do it in one season. We've had to use two seasons to get that job done.
Right. Because you've built coasters from the ground up.
Yes.
Where there's been nothing there.
Right.
And this one, Mean Streak, there's a lot of coaster there. But can you actually say, even though there's a lot of coaster already there, there's actually more work to be done there by you than there was, even from one on the ground up?
Well, surprisingly enough, the work that we put into the rebuilds if you were to measure the difference from new to the rebuilds, there's not a big difference. What we're doing with the old wood coasters, we're just saving them and we're making them into a new modern coaster. There's a little bit less work because of a little bit of structure that we, you know, don't have to build and so forth. But in reality, it's you know, you can build new structure almost as fast as you can, you know, by rebuilding. Not quite, but of course, you save, you know, you save a lot of money. You know, you don't have to buy a lot of product and so forth. But but the time it takes to remodel is you know, it's, there's a fair amount of time in it. So the Main Street was a big deal, big job.
Okay, so last year not so much. This year, 5 new coasters. Can we talk just a second about the future? I know you can't get into the specifics, and that's not what I'm going to ask. But you've only got one coaster overseas. Are we going to see Rocky Mountain Construction expand their overseas presence at all?
Yes.
Okay.
It's being done.
It's being done.
Yes.
And is this being done on a one-off basis again, or is there going to be multiple new Rocky Mountain Construction locations?
Multiple.
Yes. And... will there be different oceans to cross to get to these, or are they all across the same ocean? I'm going too far there?
I can't.
Am I getting too specific?
You know what?
World.
Okay, I can tell you this. We're going to Holland right away.
Going to Holland right away?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, so there's another European one coming.
Yeah, another European one, yeah.
But that's all you can really say.
Yeah.
You can't say if there's going to be one on a different continent.
Okay, well,
we understand. It's fine. Right. Like I said, just whatever you can tell us, because we really look forward to it. And I know that not everybody can come to America, but everybody wants to ride a Rocky Mountain Construction roller coaster, so it's nice if you can bring it on to them.
You know what? All I'm going to say is, we are booked. We are very busy, and we are booking into the future, you know.
Yes.
Yeah.
All right, Fred. Thanks once again for all your time. We really appreciate it. I'm not going to push it anymore. I'll be seeing you at other openings. Maybe there's more that you can discuss then.
Okay.
And hopefully at least by IAPA again this November, we'll be able to talk about some of the new
things.
We'll
have new information.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah.
Thank you very much for your time, Fred.
Okay.
I really appreciate it.
Thank you.